Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, that hilarious homo sapien, Gene Rayburn.
What's that?
Yeah, here we go. Whatever it was... Here's a girl I just love to play games with because she's good, and I expect she's going to be good today, too. Here's Sherry Henry.
She's right here. You say where I come from. And the next man has gone from off-Broadway to Broadway to movies to television. If he isn't out of breath by now, he should be. It's Alan Alda.
Well, here's somebody who proved a long time ago what women's lib has been showing us lately, that the smarter they are, the nicer they are. Arlene Francis.
Here he is, that prince of good fellows, an odd fellow, Larry Blyden.
Good morning, all bodies.
Hello.
Everybody's very sportive and very well, right, elegantly groomed today. That's a beautiful scarf, Arlene. Really a beauty.
Thank you, dear.
But those of you at home who can't see it, it's a shame, because it's sort of gold and tan and
it's
brown.
It's yours.
Oh, just what I've always wanted. Listen, we have a lovely show lined up for today, so why mess around? Would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Lawrence Alexander. Where are you from, Florence?
I'm living in New York now.
All right. Panel, Florence Alexander is the head of an all-female company which provides a service. We will now show the audience what her line is. In case you're interested, she also wears patchouli, and it's lovely.
Thank you.
And let's start the questioning with Alan Alda.
What is patchouli, a kind of chewing gum?
Was it,
no. No, perfume? It's a scent.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
I just never heard that name.
It's an herb.
Oh, terrific.
P-A-T-C-H-O-U-L-I.
Is this patchouli service that you perform, does this bring you into contact with people?
Yes, it does.
Does it... Do you deal
with... It's a tangential connection, though, Alan. She comes in contact with them, but the service she provides is not essentially about them.
I see.
What are you saying?
Is the service that you do connected with any kind of equipment?
Connected with...
How did you mean, Alan?
Well, I mean, do you use equipment?
Some, yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it... Is the does the service that you do require a more brain power than body power?
A little of both.
But I would say a little more on body than thought processes in this case.
Okay.
Okay, one down, nine to go, Arlene.
You said, Miss Alexander, you're a part of an all-woman organization. Is that correct?
Yes.
Is it a job that very often men do, more often than women?
Yes.
Does it require a certain amount of stamina and strength?
Yes.
Are you in the moving business?
No.
Not that much strength, right? Two down and eight to go, Gene.
I take it we can rule out the fact that you would not give us a body rub or anything like that. That requires strength in your hands to...
You can rule that out.
Okay.
At least it's part of a professional expertise. Yeah. What you do in your spare time is nobody's business.
Now, if if this requires strength, is it something in which you'd have to wear a special uniform?
No.
You don't wear anything special?
No.
Oh.
Well, you wouldn't do it dressed as you are now.
That's what I mean.
For example.
No, but nothing special.
$3.07 to go, Sherry.
Would you do some sort of maintenance or repair work?
Generally in that field, you could say.
Would it be done on buildings or around buildings? Rather than outside?
Inside rather than outside.
Well, so on a building, inside or outside, but rather than in the great outdoors.
All right.
Yes.
Pretty casual.
Would some of these buildings be private homes?
Yes.
Would it have to do with the things that make buildings function, like plumbing or air conditioning or roofs or...
No. No.
Well, unfortunately, we're out of time, so I have to throw them all over. You want to make a guess?
Window washer.
No? What'd you say, Gene?
She paints buildings.
Right, she's a house painter.
House painter, yeah. Window washer.
Still, you got it. Jim, you got it. Florence is the head of her own house painting company, which she calls Women Can Do. Do you think women make better house painters than men?
Well, they try harder, and they're more conscious of what a woman expects of her home and the care that they want. And we try, anyway, we personally try to consider the home as place where someone lives.
Do you ever hire any men to do house painting for you?
Well, let's say they're welcome, but not too many people apply. Not too many men apply to a company called Women Can Do.
I see. That's interesting. If they did, would you hire them if they were any good, do you think?
Of course.
That's terrific. Thank you for being with us on What's My Line.
It's lovely.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Direct control of the board. Take it back.
On television, Simeon.
Game Show Network. Have you played today?
Here I go, Peter, honey. Don't you know that I'm loving you?
Time has come today.
Come experience psychedelic 60s, the hottest collection of 60s hits ever.
Look up to the sky, see your eyes, a funny kind of yellow.
Wow, babe, you make my heart sing.
Every sense of compliments, meaningless nouns. Turn on, tune in, turn your eyes around.
Get Psychedelic 60s for just $12.99 on compact disc or double-length cassette. That's 21 underground classics. Then audition other great classic rock albums. There's no minimum to buy. Cancel anytime.
Born to be wild.
Psychedelic 60s is not sold in stores, so don't wait. Call now.
To order Guitar Rock, call 1-800-795-5588. That's 1-800-795-5588. Or send $12.99 plus $3.99 shipping and handling to Guitar Rock, Department 12, Richmond, Virginia, 23280.
Okay, panel, you did beautifully on that one. Let's see what happens this time. Would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Walt? Kavanaugh. Where are you from?
I'm from San Mateo, California.
Okay. Walter Kavanaugh, panel, is listed in the Guinness Book of World Records as the owner of the largest collection of something in existence. We will now show the audience what Mr. Kavanaugh collects. And we'll start the game with Arlene Francis.
Thank you. Mr. Cavanaugh, is it what you collect? Could I hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Is it anything associated in any way with the sporting world?
No.
One down, nine to go, Gene.
San Mateo is grape country. Can we assume that it has nothing to do with grapes?
You can assume that, yes.
Yeah. And are the ones that you have collected, are they very old?
No.
Two down, eight to go, Sherry.
Are they or have they ever been alive, Mr. Cavanaugh?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Alan.
Are the things that you collect made of metal in any way?
Some of them.
I take it they were used for something in their own right at one time.
No.
Well, four down and six to go, Arlene. Well, wait a minute. Let's go back for a minute on that question. What did you mean, Alan, when you said that?
Well, I mean that that they were made or found and used and bought and sold for some purpose.
Right. Four down and six to go, Arlene.
Oh. So it is something that is not manufactured. Is that correct?
No.
It is correct.
Five down and five.
Wait a minute now. I don't
know. It is not manufactured.
It is not manufactured.
Well, oh, it is manufactured.
It's manufactured.
It is manufactured.
We're going to stick together. We're going to get through here. We're going to fool them if we keep cool. It is a manufactured thing.
It is a manufactured.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
Gene?
How can it is manufactured.
Mm-hmm. Does it have any moving parts?
No.
Six down and four to go, Sherry.
These are not old. Was that a...
That's correct.
And they are partly mineral. Are they also partly vegetable?
No.
Seven down, three to go, Alan.
I'm telling you, you've completely confused me because you have indicated so far that this is manufactured but useless.
No.
Is it not useless? I mean, can we rule out that it's useless?
Yes, you can rule that out.
Yes, you can rule out that it's useless. But what you said before was that it's used for something, as in a tool, which, of course, it is not used for.
Oh, you're right. All right. But so it has some use.
Right.
Well, if you were to use it, would it touch your body?
No.
I have to turn them all over. Does anybody have any notion at all?
Does it contain anything?
No, it is credit cards. His collection is a credit card. How many credit cards are in your collection?
At the present time, there's 283 different credit cards that have all been issued to me.
Now, how did you get started collecting credit cards?
This is the dumbest thing I ever heard in my life.
Unless, of course, you happen to make little seat covers with funny words on them. Now then, how did you happen to get started?
Well, a friend and I got together one night over a cup of coffee, and we decided to make a bet out of the most ridiculous thing we could think of. And the only thing we could come up with was to collect credit cards. It seemed like a perfectly harmless, useless, and free hobby. And we've just been going
every... A free hobby, that's true, it would be.
Well,
Where do you keep them?
How free is it?
Just cost you post it, just about it.
Do you have them with you?
Yes, I do.
Can we see them?
Sure can.
Have you ever been turned down by a company?
Once.
Who turned you down?
Newberry's turned me down.
In Boston? You were banned in Boston, is that it?
No, it was Newberry's in Denver. I had just
received... Boo, Newberry's in Denver.
I had just received my Neiman Marcus credit card. As you know, it was in Dallas, Texas, very exclusive department store.
Let's see.
1 week later,
Newberry's
I got turned down by Newberry's.
Here they are. Well, we'll just... Because there's a lot of these, I see. Well, here's a pretty one. Backstreet, what's that?
That's a men's clothier someplace in Walnut Creek. You have to remember, about 75% of these stores I've never even been in.
But you can buy anything in any of these places.
Yes.
How's your credit rating except at Newberry's?
Otherwise, it's pretty good.
Look at this. This man has got a lot of credit cards, folks. Here's a pink one. Where is this? Clark. Where's that?
Clark's is some kind of a woman's shop in L.A.
Okay. Fine pipes, the tinderbox.
I don't even smoke.
United Airlines, they have one with a blue sky on it. That's the friendly skies, I guess, that they have there.
Look at those.
Four bags. I have them from England.
When is this one?
A couple from Mexico. and about eight or nine from Canada, as well as a few.
Oh, look at this one.
States.
This is a pretty one. The House of Rebel Shops. That's pretty.
How does he know he's the world's champ? Maybe somebody's got 300 someplace.
I've applied and
Some other kook someplace may have.
Here's one for Sandra Joy. What does she sell?
Joy?
Women's hosiery, and I'm a bachelor.
I tell you, this is some. Oh, here's a pretty one. Kerosene's.
They just mailed it to me because they wanted it in my collection.
That really is incredible. How are we doing?
Oh, we're not even. Oh, we're getting there.
Look at this. This is unbelievable. Arnold Cousin. It must be sort of tough to get this in your hip pocket, huh?
He carries it in his purse.
Here's a pretty one. What is this? Wall and camera. Do you ever use any of them?
I don't use any of these things. There's no use to. I have never paid a cent in interest on credit cards.
Look what we've come to the end of. Thank you for being with us on What's My Line. It's really been fun.
Thank you.
Okay, so long, Walt. We'll be back with more of What's My Line and the appearance of our mystery guest right after this message.
Oh, no, I forgot Valentine's Day!
Don't panic. A dozen red roses are always the perfect gift. That is, if they didn't drop dead in days and cost over $60. This year, give her beautiful silk roses that last a lifetime. Forever Roses, for only $19.95. She'll be delighted when Forever Roses are delivered right to her door in a professional florist box filled with a dozen of the finest silk roses and a personalized greeting card, all for just $19.95. But wait, call today and we'll include a second dozen absolutely free. That's two dozen long-stem roses handcrafted from the finest silk to stay as beautiful as the day you sent them. Our drivers are standing by, and we guarantee delivery for Valentine's Day. Call now to order Forever Roses for just $19.95. But supplies are limited, so to order for this Valentine's Day, you must call right now. Call 1-800-704-5577. That's 1-800-704-5577.
We all do dumb things. Fortunately, paying too much for car insurance doesn't have to be one of them. Geico Direct. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
baby love, I need you. Oh, how I need your love.
What makes his skin so fresh and irresistible? Try Pampers Baby Fresh Wipes with Moisture Pillow Quilting. They contain just the right amount of moisture to help leave skin clean and fresh. And they're gentler than the other leading brand.
Baby love, baby love.
Pampers Baby Fresh. Pamper the skin they're in.
Okay, we're back, and it's time for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds all in place,
yes,
panel?
Sir. Yes.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, if you don't get it, you'll be the only ones in North America who don't know, right? We'll go one question at a time, and let's start with Alan Alda.
Well, I have to presume that you are a performer on television.
Yes.
Arlene?
Are you part of a series on television?
No.
Jean?
Sorry to hear you're out of work. Let's see. When you work in television, is it in a comedy show? Is it, you do comedy?
Yes.
Sherry?
Do you also sing?
Yes.
Alan?
Have you ever worked with inanimate partners?
No.
Arlene?
Have you also appeared in the theater as a star?
Yes.
Jean?
Oh, it's a television in the theater. Are you working in the theater now?
No.
Sherry?
Are you in a nightclub performance here now?
No.
Alan?
Well, you sound like three people that I know. Do I know you personally?
No.
Arlene?
You must be the only one.
Yeah.
From that response in the audience. Now, you do sing.
Mm-hmm.
Do you, for the most part, appear in musicals rather than straight plays?
No.
I'm sorry, our time is up. Panel, take off your mask. This is Phyllis Diller.
You did it, Phyllis.
You fooled us.
I know.
But do you realize what's happened to Phyllis? She had that operation, and now she is... Are you ready for this? Field and Stream. Phyllis Diller is the first centerfold. And she's gorgeous in it. You look like you hooked a big one there.
Yes, that's
why we didn't get her. Since she's had the operation, none of us knew her.
even with your blindfolds on.
I tell you, all I can see since Dad is that they let you out.
Oh, that's sweet.
That's sweet.
Oh, listen, I tell you, it's such a joy to stump the panel because never before has
never.
It ever happened. I've whistled and you got me. I finally decided I must have some kind of an odor.
It's heaven, whatever it is. Phyllis, thank you for being
thank
with
you.
Us.
It's thank you. Thank you. Goodbye.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Super Bowl rivals, championship players, a gridiron legend. Do these football greats have what it takes to win a game show?
Do you have anything to do with football?
Yes.
Watch Super Game Saturday, starting 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
New Ziploc containers, test number 12. Both of these containers can go into the microwave. One of them doesn't always make it. Ziploc, all you ever wanted in a container. New Ziploc containers, test number 23. These containers cost about the same. But how do they really stack up? Ziploc, all you ever wanted in a container.
Are you ready for a mouth-watering roast beef dinner? Oh, no! It's cooked on the outside, cold and raw on the inside. Now, cook all your food to perfection with Red Devil's Perfect Chef, the amazing new food thermometer in a fork. It's so easy to use. Just place the fork in the roaster chops, then press the button to let you know instantly when dinner is ready to serve. Imagine, no more charred chops, no more undercooked poultry, no more expensive ruined roasts from slicing to sneak a peek. With Perfect Chef, every meal is cooked to perfection. Barbecue cooking is a gourmet guessing game. Rare or raw, well done or burned. Perfect Chef lets you test individual servings. You'll know just when to serve well-done sizzling sausage. You'll know the perfect time for succulent medium-rare steaks. And you'll know the exact time to serve rare, juicy burgers. No matter how you like it, they're cooked to order, cooked to perfection. Ordinary thermometers are hard to read, and they sit in the oven for hours. But Perfect Chef works instantly, so you can use the same unit on all the different courses. Check your lunch and broil in the broiler. Check your casserole in the microwave. Check your baked potatoes in the oven. Don't slash and slice up your stovetop masterpiece. With Perfect Chef, you'll know it's done with just a gentle touch. Undercooked pork can be dangerous to your health, but Red Devil's Perfect Chef lets you select a safe, healthy setting for all of your meats. Perfect Chef, made of stainless steel with solid-state circuitry and a full one-year warranty. Now yours for only $19.95. Call now, and as a special bonus, you'll receive the express sealer. Keep chips, crisp, sugar soft, leak proof, and airtight. It's a $20 value free. Perfect Chef and Express Sealer from Red Devil. The perfect compliments to your gourmet kitchen. Remember, if you don't see the Red Devil, it's not a perfect chef.
Call now to have the Red Devil Perfect Chef rushed to your home for the low introductory price of just $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Your Perfect Chef comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Plus, call now and you'll also receive the Express Sealer absolutely free. Call the toll-free number now.
Okay, would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Charmian Cliff.
Hi, Charmian. Yes? Where are you from, Charmian?
Original England. I now live in Arizona.
Arizona. Oh, is that beautiful? Okay, panel, Charmian Cliff is the women's champion of a new sport, which is really a combination of two existing sports. Mm. You must find out what this combination is. We'll first show the audience the name of the new sport. We'll start the game with Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Larry. Ms. Cliff, is there an object involved in this sport? Such as a ball or a bat or a rope or anything?
Well,
any
yes,
kind
I
of object.
Suppose there is.
There is an object.
Mm-hmm.
And is it done on terra firma?
Partly.
Partly.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Is there a machine involved, such as an airplane or a car or...
Yes.
There is.
Yes.
And is it an automobile?
No.
One down, nine to go, Sherry.
Well, do you do... One sport that you do is ordinarily done on land, is that right?
Yes.
And the other sport that you do is ordinarily done on water?
No.
No, it had to
two
be...
Two down and eight to go, Ellen.
Well, it can only be, I guess, in the air. Is it partly done on land and partly in the air?
Yes.
That sounds terribly dangerous. and a machine is involved. Does the machine have wheels on it?
Yes.
Well, is it a two-wheeled machine?
I don't know.
Okay.
I think probably not, Alan.
Yeah.
I think it probably is not a two-wheeled machine. But it may be.
Well, unless... put this thing back and I'll ask another question.
That's two and a half down and seven and a half to go.
Right. Do you spend some time in the air?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you spend some... Does this machine fly? Does it have wings? It uses air currents in some way.
Yes.
Huh? Now, do you get as part of the game? The game is ordinary. I guess the game you play a game in the air that's ordinarily played on the ground. Is that it?
It isn't a game.
No, it really isn't. I'm sorry. We're out of town. The combination is parachuting and skiing.
Yeah.
Para-skiing. Is the name of the sport.
Skiing.
Parachuting and skiing. Would you tell us how it works, Charmian?
It's two separate events, parachuting and skiing, and they combine the scores to find out who's the winner.
You mean you parachute and then you take off the parachute and then put on skis and then go skiing?
Yes. You land as close to a target as you can get, and they measure the distance. Then the skiing, you ski down a giant slalom course and they time you for that.
That's doing it the hard way.
It sure is.
You don't land with the skis on your feet, do you?
No.
No.
That's a good break. Listen, we're out of time, everybody. We have to go. We'll see you before you know it. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. We'll see you.
This is Chet Gould speaking for What's My Line, a Mark Ritson, Bill Taubman production. This is Francis Cowans, live on with Teller. This program was recorded.
Want to see more occupations? Tune in to the classic version of What's My Line with John Daly, Sunday at 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific. It's time to register. To play our interactive game shows, call 1-800-537-GAME now. It's fast, it's fun, and it's free. You only have to register once to play forever on Game Show Network.